In this lesson, we will learn to draw a single line diagram in ETAP. We have our window open here. We are in the edit mode. I will go over here and click on the show grids option. I will have a reference of my single line diagram, so I will know the alignment. And let us draw something simple. Okay, then I will go over here to the elements toolbar, click on a power grid, and I will have to drag it over here and click here. So the elements are pulled from the elements toolbar like that. And let us add a transmission line. Transformer. And let me see. Okay, we'll need a cable and a load. So this is it, and we will need buses, of course. So I'll click on the bus option over here and come here and click over here. So again, if I want to go and pick up a bus, I will have to come to the elements toolbar. Another way of doing is that I will go and double click over here, so this will remain selected, and I will click like that over here, and I will press escape to remove the selection. Next, we will have to connect all these elements together. So I will come to this connection point over here. So as you can see, this turns to pink, and I will click on the pink over here and drag it to the bus until the bus becomes pink. And you can also drag the elements like this. I will drag the line like this and go to the bus until it turns pink and leave it there and drag this back. Okay, so let's go about connecting all our systems. When drawing a single line diagram, it is best to make sure everything aligns in a perfect way so that it can be pleasing to your eyes. So one option to do this to select your single line diagram. Right click, then I will go to the alignment option over here. So you have different alignments. I will select this one over here. So everything comes in a single line. Then another thing you can do is over here, I have only a single branch from the transformer. If you want to make another branch, then it's better to make a template of the current branch, so I don't have to make another branch from the start. So I will just select this over here, right click on this, or I will go to this option over here that is add to template. I click this over here and I will select a template name. Let me put it as 3, then I will save it over here. Okay, template was successfully generated. I will click on OK. Then I will go over here to get my template, or I can simply right click over here and get from template. And I will take this template. I'll click on OK, and here we see the same has come as a template. So I'll put it over here and I will connect it to this bus. Also, we can drag this bus like this over here, and you can also change your connections like this, so it could be more appealing. For every element, there will be a terminology such as bus 1, bus 2, bus 3, and so on. So when you are making templates, you will have this cable 1 and cable 1-1. The next feature that I would like to discuss is the system dumpster. let me show you how it works. So let me select a bus. Okay, I'll select a bus, and when I put the bus over here, so it numbers it as bus number 5, and I'm going to delete this bus number 5, and then I'm going to look into the dumpster, which is over here, the system dumpster. And what I see is that the bus 5 is being in the dumpster. So if I want to bring back the elements to my single line diagram, so I could go back to the dumpster, then I would come here and I would copy this, and I will go back to the single line diagram and I would paste it over here. So this over here. Okay. Now the bus has come back. This is bus number 6. Now when I go back to the dumpster, I can still see my bus number 5 over here. So if you want to bring the element from the system dumpster, before it was bus 5, now this is bus 6. If you want to make this bus 5, then you will have to go to the system dumpster and delete this bus over here. I will go and delete this, and when I come back to my single line diagram, and I will have to select another bus and I put over here. See, this becomes the bus number 5, and this is how it is done. So it is simply like a recycle bin. So I will delete both of these and go to the dumpster and see, I have deleted both of these. You can see it in the system dumpster. And the next feature I would like to show you is the composite network. For very large systems, you will like to create some subsystems, so it could be more understandable. For that purpose, we have the composite network over here. So I will click on the composite network and I will put it here. So this becomes network 1. So I will connect it to this bus. Okay. Then I will double click on this, then it will open into the subsystem. So I will again go here and show grid lines. Then let me connect this to something like, okay, we'll connect a static load over here to the bus number 3. Let me go to my main window. This is the main system, and from the main system we go to the subsystem. Actually, this is all connected to a single system. That's all for this lesson. So, see you in the next lesson.